Hi there. I just want to do a video. And, this video is going to be, well, I don't plan it, so it's not going to be anything. It'll just be whatever comes out. You know, if you notice on these videos, I don't really say my name at the start of the videos, because that's not who I am anyway. The spiritual awakening showed me that we are not our names, the labels that our parents give us, that we are just infinity. Infinite nothingness. And logic would tell you that at some stage there has to be a nothing. That's without science. But what does that mean? Well, I've thought about it a long time, and I think that this is a dream. Right, I think it's all a dream. I can't think of much else. You can come from nothing, you can be from nothing. The closest we can get to nothing is when we're sleeping at night and we're not dreaming of anything. And we're not, like, consciously awake. But then we are awake. So does this nothing produce awareness all by itself? Is it? That means it would be the awareness, wouldn't it? That means that what we are is just pure infinite awareness. And it's all the same self experiencing itself as separate. It means that all the names of gods and all the forms and all the things that we think we are real are all illusory and illusions. It means that it's just nothingness slash awareness, having a dream all the time, and that it's the same thing. And the stupid thing is, you get people who talk about, oh, this God existed here and that. But if it's all the same awareness, then why are you talking about a separate God? It doesn't make sense. It's just a stupid thing. That's why I've never been interested in religion or what God or Jesus or any of these people. Because if it's the same awareness, I wasn't even interested in them before this awakening, but now I'm like, it's even more crazy. If it's the same consciousness, then why would I bow to Jesus? Why would I bow to anyone if it's me? I'm not going to bow to myself, am I? I'd be stupid. Bow in the mirror, that you really have to be confident to do that, but, or not even confident, probably crazy. But at the start of this video, I had you saw the doctor person probably preparing a vaccine, and that's kind of what's going on as well with the coronavirus. But you see, again, what is it that makes someone create something, or create something in a laboratory? It's their perceptual state, their mind, their awareness. And I personally believe that the reason that this has come, the climate change is there, and now it's coronavirus, the climate change hasn't worked. So they've created this coronavirus because the climate change isn't working. People aren't buying it, right? So the system knows that what's happening is the awareness is changing. Therefore, the dream changes. It's all a dream. What can you be if you come from nothing? A dream. That's the most you can be. Or infinitely more, because it's infinity. It's like there's over 7 billion people on this planet, and yet one person will think that their views are right. It's insanity. You know, but regarding reality, things don't get there by accident. Nothing happens by accident. What happens is you've got the herd lower down, But they don't see that there's actually a farmer there with the shepherds. And the dogs are the ones in the, you know, in the nice clothes, or the doctors, or the certified people. But they've been certified by the shepherd. And the shepherd is dictating all. The shepherd is, the truth of it is in fact us. This is the big thing that people don't realize, that we are the system. The system is not separate from us, the system is us. We are the many. But it's an illusion within this dream that people still have, that everything's like separate, but it's all oneness. It's all the same thing. Like I was saying earlier about awareness, it's all the same awareness, experiencing itself. It's like when I say Gaia, my perception isn't a separate female god. It's all the same oneness. So I am Gaia. So that's how my perception is just oneness all the time now. You know, but when you're talking about nothingness and going to the core like that, I was watching this scientist guy the other day on YouTube, and he was talking about how they found out how everything did come from nothing. And they've even got this piece of machinery that I was on one of the videos, that can actually go back to the exact date. I don't know when the date was, but they've got this stuff, this machine that can go back to the nothing. But, you know, and even the interviewer, he didn't like it. And he offended a lot of people, the guy, because the religious people don't like to hear that stuff. I was telling my mum the other day that everything comes from nothing. And she got upset with me and was refusing to acknowledge the fact that everything does have to come from nothing. See? But the other problem is that if there is a nothing, it would mean there's not actually ever a start point, because nothingness is infinity. It means that although science can go back to the nothing, it means that we would never experience it, because it doesn't exist. You can't experience a nothing where it doesn't exist, can you? You can't experience something that doesn't exist. The nothing doesn't exist. So all there is really, I think, is just dreams. And all we ever have is this moment, this presence. That's all I think there is. If you observe it, that's all you're ever in is present. That's all there ever is. It's all only ever this moment. But you're thinking of someone else, but it's just your imagination's thinking of someone else, somewhere else. It's just here. I am in real denial of the fact that there is two or another person. The more I go in this path, the more I meditate, the more I'm observing this oneness, I'm realizing more and more how it really is all me, that there isn't anyone else. Like, even the animals are me. It's all the same awareness, like I've been saying, experiencing itself. But it's the ego that makes you think that you're separate, because the ego is the thing that attaches to an idea of self. Take away that, there's no self. You take away the all the ideas that we have about ourselves, that doesn't exist anymore. So that's what we are, just awareness. And that's what I believe the nothing is. infinite awareness. And I'm just going to leave it there. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you.